Hi everyone, Monica Moore here, nurse practitioner at Illume Fertility, and today on this session of Ask Monica, we're going to talk about how to figure out your due date should you become pregnant after an IVF cycle. So the due date really is the transfer date plus 266 minus the age of the embryo, which for most people is going to be 5. So it's the transfer date plus 266 minus 5. We don't figure when you go, if you achieve a pregnancy and you're not doing IVF, then what your doctor would ask you is when was the first day of your last period? Well, whenever you do a fertility cycle, we sort of manipulate your days. We might put you on birth control pills or other medications. So we cannot rely on the last menstrual cycle. So what we do know is the day that you got your trigger shot, the day that you had a retrieval. So if you're doing a fresh transfer, the day you had a transfer. If you're doing a frozen embryo transfer or you're doing a pregnancy using donor eggs, you just have the transfer. You don't have the retrieval or the HCG injection. So we try to figure it out these days by transfer date. So the so if you had, let's say, a day 5 transfer, then which most people have, if you had PGTA, which is the genetic testing of the embryos, you had a day 5 transfer, then you count 261 days after your transfer date. This might be, this date might be, even though we know the date for sure, then once you have an ultrasound in pregnancy, early ultrasound is very good and helpful for calculating the due date and the embryo age, even though we know what it is from having IVF. We would be measuring what's called the crown rump length, or the head to butt sort of the embryo or early fetus, to then compare to your due date to make sure that everything is sized appropriately. What you might see is us something with these kind of handy dandy pregnancy wheels, which we get, and when we're talking to you, we would then calculate your due date based on your transfer date, which obviously we would know. And like I said, it would be transfer date plus 261 days if you have a day 5 embryo. If you have a day 3 embryo, obviously it would be your transfer date plus 263 days. So if you're ever not sure, I know online there you can do a calculator for this. You would Google, you know, calculate your due date after IVF. But we help you obviously figure it out. You can ask us, you know, as early on, and then during your pregnancy, ultrasounds or scans, we kind of correlate the health of the pregnancy with the size of the embryo growing appropriately according to when we know your due date is and what we should be seeing on that early ultrasound. So I hope this is helpful. Thanks so much. See you on the next episode.